Hello everyone and welcome back to White Tone Racing. Honestly, I didn't want to make today's video. Because it seemed to me something a little too banal, already seen, known. But actually, after the video posted on Facebook in which many of you asked me to make a specific video, I decided to talk to you today about checking the static balancing of the flywheel and correcting the static imbalance. So, before proceeding with all the verification operations first, and then balancing, I must make a very important clarification. That is, the flywheel that we're going to see today, and that we'll see to be statically unbalanced, and I'm sure that it is also dynamically unbalanced because mounted on the engine, it made it vibrate more than normal. So this is the certainty that I have. If you are starting from a flywheel that you have not tested and therefore do not know if it actually vibrates or doesn't make the engine vibrate, be careful because small static imbalances may be due to a dynamic balancing of the flywheel itself. So, by statically balancing it, you can worsen what is the standard balancing. This is not the case because, as I told you, I have tried this flywheel and the engine actually vibrated. So it's also unbalanced. Since I can't balance it dynamically because I don't have the necessary equipment, I'll do it statically. So here we are ready at the work table. First of all, let's see what we need. There is the usual outfit, which is this. Self-built, but they sell it already made. Even better than this, which is very handcrafted. It's not necessary, even nicer enough. The Pinasco flywheel that you have already seen in the Facebook video. This flywheel here in the video I made, many understood it as wanting to denigrate Pinasco. In reality, that was never the point. The video was simply educational, especially since this flywheel has also been tampered with. It was a bit filed down. Something was done to it. It was used. A friend gave it to me, and so here's why I use it. Just to show you. What you'll see is just that. Not to denigrate one brand or the other. There is also a Parmakit flywheel, machine from Solid with a nominal weight of 2.4 kilograms. I didn't weigh it. This maybe we'll see later. So we need this tool, which is nothing more than a cone that reproduces the crankshaft, the flywheel side of the crankshaft. A nut, a washer, and then the pneumatic screwdriver that tightens. So let's put this in its place. Washer, nut, and then with the pneumatic screwdriver, here it is, equipped with a long sleeve, we screw in. The first thing to do is to place the flywheel on the instrument here. I'll try to position myself so you can see. And identify what the heavy part of the flywheel is statically. We help each other with a piece of chalk to mark the point. Then, with small solicitations, we move the flywheel to see where it stops more easily. We can already mark this point with chalk, that is the lightening I'm going to practice is 180 degrees from the highest point, so I made a sign. I'll proceed. It tends to return to the position. I'll make another sign. Always at 180 degrees. That the imbalance is this could also be understood from the conditions of the flywheel itself. Because here, probably because it rubbed, let's see if I can show it to you, here there is no plastic, it has been filed. So probably either the shaft has turned and then it managed to rub on the crankcase, or in any case something has happened. With the sole purpose of giving you more information, but it's not the subject of this video, let's see how the Parmakit flywheel, machine from solids, behaves. Even if this reveals a static imbalance, I wouldn't touch it, because I still don't have the certainty that the static imbalance compensates for the dynamic balance. So, since the only way I have to verify this is to mount the flywheel on the engine, after having mounted it, I will evaluate if the vibrations are too many or right, correct. Let's verify. As you can see, by making small touches, the flywheel follows the thrust and then stops. So there is no static imbalance, as it was for the other flywheel instead. We have repositioned our flywheel back in its place, and we are ready for a new check. It's still coming back, you see? So the hole made is not enough. Again, thanks to the drill press, we made an additional hole close to the one already drilled. We've put the cone on for verification, and we're ready to go back to our instrument. Let's see if it'll be enough. Okay, go back a little bit more, see? So, drill a third hole this time, just closer to the center, because we're almost there. Let's verify. Not there yet. Fourth hole drilled. Let's go back to checking, and we should be there this time. See, it's not coming back. It only moves in the direction in which I impart strength. It doesn't come back. So we can say that the operation is finished. Today I showed you a handcraft method of balancing the flywheel. But be careful, you can't mess around with flywheels. If you have any doubt that your flywheel is unbalanced, before venturing into homemade balancing, unless you have the tools and the skills to evaluate the work, our advice is always rely on professionals, on workshops, on capable people. So you don't mess with the flywheels. If a flywheel explodes, it's easy for you to get very, very hurt. If you like this video, leave a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Remember, White Pawn Racing is not a workshop, but an amateur sport association that works on engines only for sport purposes and only for its associates.